It all began 27 years ago, doing filing, answering the phones, helping the medical assistant with patients and cleaning rooms. In 2001, we were told that another doctor would be buying the practice. Guess who the doctor was? Dr. Steen, of course. At that time, my co-workers and me got very worried as we assumed that we were about to be replaced by the new doctor's own staff. Then things got a little happen. A year later, Dr. Steen asked me if I want to be his office manager. At first, I say no. But then the Dr. Steen made the following statement to me. Lidia, do you really want to spend the rest of your life cleaning and admitting patients into the room? Nothing wrong with that, of course. But Dr. Steen was to try to make a point for me to be in a better position and make more money, right? I know I always made my very best. But now, after 27 years, it's time for me to retire and enjoy more life with my beloved husband, kids, and grandkids. I'm sure I will miss you all, but now let's just enjoy the party, and thanks again. Thank you very much to everybody. I'm very happy and very nervous.
Yeah, so it's kind of been a very pleasant journey. In 2001, I took over the practice, and there was another office manager, and I asked Lydia, I said, you know, will you become my office manager? And you can imagine, basically, has anybody seen Lydia get angry?
No.
You know, no. They've seen me go up and down, especially the people who work with me in the lab. They have seen my wrath. But Lydia is so even-tempered, and sort of she managed the practice, she managed me, she managed everything so beautifully. Actually, I really have not done anything. So I'm very scared now being around Lydia. Yeah. But she is one of a kind, and she's so special that Downey Cardiomedical Group and my practice will not have an office manager, because nobody can be like Lydia. So no one can be like Lydia, so we are going to get along and do things in a different way, but she's such a special person, and I hope that as a person and as a friend, I always get the benefit of your advice, of your being a friend, being in our life, and that will make me very, very happy. So before we do dinner, we're going to do a small game. If you kind of look underneath your table, there's a packet which is there. There's a box. Every table has a box.
Where?
Oh yeah, it's over there. It's by your foot. It's by your foot.
So this is like a, everybody has it? Every table has it? Okay, just keep it in the center. So this is a small game we are going to play. I'm going to read a speech, and when I say write, so one person should from the table just grab the packet, and when I say right, it should go to the right, and when I say left, it should go to the left. And at the end of the game, whoever has it will be taking it home from that particular table. Is everyone ready? Okay, so here we go. Everyone has a pack, so each one person should start the game. Everyone, keep it in your hand. Yeah, one person should start the game. Have it in your hand.
Start with the center.
Not able. Daniela, have it. You guys have it. Okay. So here we go. Lydia knew that today was the right day to go out and search for the right retirement home to spend her senior years. If only she could figure out where she had left her keys. She thought she had left them on the counter, but she looked left and right and did not see them.
That's going back to you.
Where is your pack? Is it moving?
Yeah.
puzzled, she went right to the living room to see if she had left them there. There they were. She had left them on the coffee table. Right away, she reached to pick them up and noticed there was hardly any water left in the vase of roses that had been sitting to the left of the TV. She would have to add water right away. She picked up the vase and headed right back to the kitchen. But on her way, she noticed a flash of light to her right. She put the vase right down to the floor and headed right to where she had seen the flash.
All right.
Oh no, a power surge has caught the two bright bulbs in the fixture.
Right
above her, able to burn right on. Well, there was nothing left to do.
Give it back.
But put some new bulbs in right away. But as she headed right to the pantry, she tripped over the vase she had left on the floor. What a mess. She was left with no choice but to clean it up and then get right back to cleaning the bulbs. She grabbed some paper towels right off the counter and got right to the business of cleaning up. It was then she noticed something shining right under the cover.
Right back.
What was it? She tried to reach it with her left hand and then her right, but it was just out of her reach. So she went right to the closet to get a clothes hanger. She turned the hanger right and then left. And then right, and then left again. Till she formed a tool that would be right under the cupboard and would certainly reach the treasure that was left under there. She eased the tool a little to the left till it was right beside the object. She gently edged it right out from under the cupboard. It was her grandson's. She had left at her house last weekend. She would have to call him right away to let him know that his toy was there.
Right.
As she headed right towards the phone,
yay, got it.
She saw the clock to her left.
You're right back.
4 p.m. 4 p.m. There wasn't enough time left now to go look for a retirement home. She's looking for a retirement home, remember that? Where had the time gone? She would have to make plans to head out right away tomorrow morning, but first she needed a nap. So whoever has the package now, and Elsie for creating this label for Lidia. It really goes well. My especially teenagers.
Yeah, you got it.
And you are such a cutie that goes along exactly with what Lidia is. Lidia is a cutie. And the office people make this thing for you, Elsie, Maria, and Nancy, and Lupe. And I really want to thank all of you who put in all the effort in making this possible. So mix up, drink up, and we'll serve the dinner now.
Awesome.